Thank you for joining me for another edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Today I have on with me from TopicThunder.com, Alyssa Fragnoli. How are you doing today, Alyssa?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. I'm sure you're saying that good with a shot of vodka behind it after the Dwight Howard trade.
No, not even. Not even. People keep asking me, "Oh, are you worried?" And I said, "No, not even a little."
Why aren't you worried?
You know, maybe I should be. You know, I don't know. I'm just, you know, first of all, we don't know if Dwight Howard's even going to be ready by the start of the season. So that's one thing. So, I mean, everyone's just assuming that that's going to be the case. And then second of all, when he comes back, we don't know how he's going to bounce back from this injury. So, I mean, we'll see what he's like. We don't know if he's going to be performing at the same level he was before or if this injury is going to linger, you know, or cause another one. We don't know. And I just have this gut feeling that it's not going to work out the way that everybody thinks it's going to. And you know, you can't just put a bunch of all-stars together and think in 1 year it's going to work. I mean, even Miami showed that it takes a couple of years. And, you know, I don't think the Steve Nash trade really did much for them. They needed to get faster and younger. They didn't do that with Nash, and Nash can't play defense. So I'm just not convinced that it's really going to work out.
How long do you think it will take to mesh? Because, I mean, they're going to be without Howard for the beginning of the season, most likely because of the back surgery.
Mm-hmm.
What are they going to have? Jordan Hill replace him at the beginning, or Kenyon Martin if they sign him? How long do you think it takes them to gel? And, I mean, there could be another – I mean, Kobe Bryant's not the spring chicken anymore. He could get injured. How long do you think it takes this team to mesh?
I think it's going to take some time. I mean, you know, Miami showed it takes a couple of years. And one thing about the Thunder, one reason I think the Thunder mesh so well together themselves is this team, the core guys, have been together for the last 3 years. You know, to me, it takes time. And you're right, if they have, you know, Jordan Hill or someone else starting at the beginning of the season, then you make that change, you know, partway through the season, you know, you don't know how it's going to affect everybody. And I wonder, you know, how is the court going to hold both of those egos, Kobe's and Dwight's? I don't know. We'll see how that works. And you know, it takes time for people to get used to each other and get used to playing each other and knowing where each other's on the court all the time. And that takes time. And Dwight can't even practice right now, you know, so we'll see.
How about how? Do you think there's still a possibility he gets moved before the season starts, or do you think that that's not going to happen at all? Do you think it's going to be next season?
I don't think he'll get moved because I know Kobe has said publicly that he wants Powell and L.A., and I don't think the Lakers want to do anything to piss Kobe off. I think they want to keep Kobe happy, even though they did trade Fisher. So, I mean, you never know, but I don't see them getting rid of him. I mean, I don't think it would be a bad idea. I think Powell's gotten kind of soft the last couple of years. I would much rather have his brother on my team, but I don't think it's going to happen. I think this is the team that they're going to have for the season, and they still have no bench. That's the other reason I'm not worried.
Well, do you follow any Laker fans on Twitter?
Yes.
Is it annoying
Yes.
how they've been talking about Jody Meeks like he's the second coming of Jesus? And it's like, oh my God, Jody Meeks is here. Oh my God, Jody Ooh. Meeks. Jody Meeks has scored 50 in a game at Kentucky, and that's about it. He's not anything to write home about. I mean, are these Lakers fans getting a little carried away with these moves that they've made?
They are extremely carried away. They're so overconfident right now, and that's the other reason I just think it's just going to bite them. They're so full of themselves. They're like, oh, we're going to win it now. Oh, how many more rings is Kobe going to get now? Oh, he's going to pass Jordan, this, that, and the other. No. They're getting so carried away with all this, and meanwhile, I'm just, like, sitting back as a Thunder fan, just letting them talk, just letting them say whatever they want, because I know at the end of the day, the team to beat in the West is the Thunder. They proved that last season.
Do you think that the Thunder have enough up front to negate, negating Bynum and Powell last year was a little different because Bynum was disinterested. If you have a motivated Dwight and a motivated Powell Gasol, do you think that the Thunder have trouble stopping that front court?
No, well, I don't think they have trouble stopping Powell. They had no problem doing it last year, and Powell was motivated last year because they were talking about trading him. And Howard, we don't know how motivated Howard's going to be. That's, you never really know. And like I said, again, we'll see how he comes back from injury. But no, because the other reason I'm not concerned is this is not a league right now where you need a dominant center. I mean, it's helpful, but it's not like the old days where you need a dominant center to win a championship. Miami didn't have one. Boston doesn't have one. This is a fast-paced league now. It's all about the transition. It's all about the fast break, and the Thunder's better at that. So, I don't know. I'm still just not that worried. Even if Dwight Howard comes back from injury strong, and even if he is motivated, I still think the Thunder would take them in a 7-game series.
Who else in the West are you concerned about? Because really nobody else in the West has really gotten better. I mean, you can say the Clippers have gotten better, but I really don't buy that they've gotten better. The only other team in the West that's really gotten better is probably the Hornets, and everybody else has pretty much stayed pat with everything and maybe the Suns. The Suns have gotten better, I thought.
Well, the Hornets have gotten better, but you're not going to go from, a losing record to,
Oh, yeah. But I'm just saying, that's how little anybody. Right,
no,
I'm just saying that there's little been done in the West. Who do you think's that third team now?
I always worry about the Spurs. They may not make any moves. They may not make any I always worry about the Spurs because they're one of those teams that's always there. They do it quietly, too. They don't make huge moves. They're not loud. They're not in the public eye a lot, but they're always in the hunt. They're always a threat. So, I think the West is between the Spurs, the Lakers, the Thunder. I don't think anybody else can really take those three.
Do you think the Mavs end up missing the playoffs this year? Because they have gotten significantly worse. And, they've gotten O.J. Mayo and Elton Brand, whoop-de-doo. I don't see them being a playoff team with how they're currently constructed. They're going to have to get Dwight next year or something.
If they do, it'll be as like an 8th seed. They might make it barely, but that's partly because Houston's not going to be any better, and they were close last year. Phoenix, we'll see. The Grizzlies haven't gotten better. They may make it as an 8th seed. They're going to be close. They could go either way. They're going to be on the fence, I think.
What about in the rest of this trade? Bynum goes to Philly. Iguodala goes to Denver. Everybody's all over Philly. Like, they're going to be so much better with Andrew Bynum. Bynum has had one healthy season in his entire career.
Exactly, which was last
year.
It was a shortened season.
Yeah, and it's not like, have a dominant center in the East, but every other team is deeper in the East. The Knicks are deeper. The Celtics are deeper. The Heat are even. It's sad to say, but the Heat are deeper than the Sixers. The Nets are deeper than them. They just lost.
Who do the 76ers have then? They have Bynum and they have Drew Holiday.
Yeah. They lost their best player, Andre Iguodala, and their second best player, Lou Williams.
Iguodala's been there forever. It's going to be so weird seeing Iguodala in a different uniform. He's been there forever.
Do you think that him going to Denver is going to work out better than the original time an AI went to Denver from Philly?
Yeah, because I think this Denver team's better.
You think that they have a shot at being a 3 seed?
I don't know if I would go as high as 3. Definitely 4. They could make a 3. We'll see how San Antonio does because their age is going to catch up to them eventually. And we'll see how the Lakers do. They have a shot at the 3. I think they're kind of like that sleeper team, I think. They could be a threat. I don't think they're a title contender, but I think they've gotten a lot better.
If the Nuggets, what are they? They've gotten rid of the three bad contracts they've signed in the last two off seasons with Al Harrington, which thank God he got signed there instead of coming back to the Knicks. Nene, who got signed an enormous amount of money, and Aaron Aflalo. Now they got Andre Iguodala.
They got rid of Aaron Aflalo?
Yeah, he went to the Magic.
Oh, I did not know that. That kind of makes me sad.
That shouldn't make you sad. It's Aaron Aflalo. Well, I guess you are a
UCLA fan, so.
Well, he's not a franchise-changing player. He got overpaid. But now they got a decent front line of Reed and McGee. They got Iguodala, they got Danilo, and they got Ty Lawson. You think that team is deep enough to compete with a Lakers in a 7-game series this year?
No. It's close, but no. They're not deep enough, and they don't have enough experience yet. I mean, they're better. I think they would challenge them harder than last year, but I don't think they could take the Lakers or the Thunder in a 7-game series. No, not yet.
Well, and then they're with the Orlando Magic. They got all these draft picks, and they're everybody's talking about all the draft picks they got. Those teams are good that they got draft picks from. Those are going to be playoff teams, and they're protected. They're protected first round picks. So even if a team does, like, if the Lakers were to go have like 9 wins this year and get the first overall pick, the Magic still wouldn't get that pick. So these picks are going to be late first-round picks. How long do you think it takes the Magic to recover from losing Dwight? Do you think it takes as long as it took to recover from losing Shaq?
It's going to take a couple years because they're a mess. I mean, besides they got rid of their coach and they don't have Howard, and other than Howard, their team wasn't that great anyways. So, I mean, it's like they're going to take a couple years to rebuild. They need to draft some really good young players. And they kind of need to do what the Thunder did and just, like, start from scratch. Just get rid of everybody, find a coach you like, draft some young players, and just, like, build on it. That's pretty much what they need to do. They're going to suck next year, but they just need to, like, get through it.
With this Eastern Conference, the East is – I think – would you say the East is officially now better than the West?
No.
Not at all.
I think the West is still better than the East, but I think it's closer than it has been in recent years.
Well, the top five in the East is better than the top five in the West. Top to bottom, the West might be stronger.
Yeah, top to bottom, the West is definitely stronger. But it's closer than it has been in recent years. In the last few years, West has been far and away better than the East. Not even close. Now it's close.
Well, and I mean, like, I mean, everybody's all over the Lakers, all over the Heat. It's going to be a Kobe versus LeBron final. That's what everybody's talking about now. I think the Kobe-LeBron desire for a final, if it happens, it's going to be a Magic versus Jordan in the finals type of thing, where the moment had passed, and it's not quite as exciting as it would have been, say, 4 or 5 years ago when LeBron was in Cleveland. And the Lakers were at the peak of their power with Kobe and Gasol.
You know, I really don't want to see that final, and that's partly because, like, let's say that we were to get that and LeBron were to win, people would make a huge deal about it, but they would forget, you know, Kobe's, what, 33 years old now?
I think he's like 34 or 35.
Yeah, he's past his peak. He's past his prime. You have LeBron in his prime. So that's not really fair. So
yeah.
People are going to make a huge deal about it if that were to happen and say, oh, this proves LeBron's better. No, it doesn't. I mean, you have a way past his prime Kobe and in the peak of his career LeBron. That's not a fair comparison.
Well, I mean, it's like when...
The fact that people are still comparing Kobe as old as he is, and he's been in the NBA since he was 18, okay? There's a lot of miles on those tires. So the fact that Kobe is still even in these conversations says a lot about how good he is.
Well, and Kobe, it's exactly like what happened with Jordan Magic. I mean, Magic was at the tail end of his career. And if that matchup had happened maybe in 89 or 90, that would have been huge for the league. I mean, it's not like the league needed a Magic-Jordan final, but, I mean, the NBA's needed a LeBron-Kobe final. Now it doesn't really need it because the NBA is so strong. It's kind of like the Michael versus Magic.
I don't think we're going to see that final anyways. I question whether – I mean, Miami's going to be the favorite to make the final in the East, obviously, but I'm not – Wade's not getting any younger, and I think that a lot of them – I think they're going to kind of do what the Lakers did, and a lot of them are going to, like, kind of lose their drive and their motivation for a ring because they already have one. I think LeBron will still have the drive because he needs to prove he can get more than one, because when you look at all the legends, they have multiple. So I think he's going to still have the drive, but I'm not convinced that the rest of the team's really going to be as driven and as motivated as he is.
Do you think that this, I mean, if back in early 2000s, when the Lakers did the, brought in Peyton, brought in Malone, if Malone doesn't get injured, the Lakers probably beat the Pistons in the finals.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, so that, it, with all the drama and all the crap that went on behind the scenes there, it almost worked. And if it, I mean, do you think that there's a disaster lingering with these guys? With, do you think that there's, I mean, there's not nearly the egos that were going on in that locker room. I mean, it's still, I mean, do you think it goes better or worse than that team?
The Lakers?
Yeah.
I have a gut feeling it is a disaster waiting to happen. I don't know why, but it's just like this gut instinct I have it. Between the fact that I don't think their coach is the right fit for their team at all, I think the players have more respect for Kobe than the coach, and between the egos of Howard and Kobe, I think it could be a disaster waiting to happen. I'm not really sure, but I have a gut feeling it is. I mean, we'll see.
Well, are you excited about Rashard Lewis and Ray Allen reuniting in Miami?
No.
How much, I mean, with that team, I still don't buy them as being able to beat the Celtics this year. I mean, the Celtics have gotten so much better.
And I don't think Ray Allen makes the Heat any better. I love Ray Allen, and I died a little inside when he signed with the Heat because I grew up in Seattle, and he was on the Sonics, and he went to Boston, who I like, and I'm used to seeing him in green, and to see him in red, and in a team I really don't like, I died a little. But, you know, he put, like, all-time low numbers last year. You know, he struggled with injuries, not getting any younger. Rashard Lewis is, like, how old now?
He's probably he's in his 30s, and I know that, I mean, we can confirm now that Rashard Lewis did not have sex with LeBron's wife. And since he's with the Heat. But, I mean, how long has it been since Rashard Lewis has been a motivated player?
Since he was, like, in Detroit with the Pistons and they were making championships?
Yeah. Well, I mean, really. I mean, he hasn't been motivated. And
It's so long, no.
Yeah, so I don't see that working out.
I don't either. I'm not convinced that Miami's going to beat the Celtics or... I'm not convinced that they're making the championship next year. I mean, I could be. They're the favorites, obviously, but I would not be surprised to see them kind of just struggle next year.
Do you think that our beloved Chris Humphreys playing with the Nets, do you think the Nets, I think the Nets could give them a run in a 7-game series.
I think that's another one. Because it takes you're putting all these new players together. It takes time for everyone to mesh, but they're going to be a threat definitely next year. And
the only piece that they're really adding though is Joe Johnson, and I think he's a pretty easy piece to mesh in.
Got to stay healthy though. Everyone's just assuming he's going to stay healthy, and he hasn't stayed healthy in how many years? I mean, everyone's crossing their fingers if they're a Nets fan that he'll stay healthy.
Well, I mean, they got all the things. I mean, I think Gerald Wallace is a solid player. He needs to stay healthy. Brooke Lopez needs to stay healthy, and Darren Williams needs to stay healthy.
Oh, yeah.
If they all stay healthy.
If Williams doesn't stay healthy, they're screwed.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, leaving it all out to Marshawn Brooks could be a disaster.
And that's a big if. I mean, Williams hasn't been the healthiest guy in his career either.
But moving on to the Olympics, I was watching the men's diving, and could the men please just wear shorts when they dive? Do they need to wear a Speedo diving? Is there any aerodynamic thing that you gain from wearing a Speedo diving?
I don't know. I think the shorts may get in the way more or something, or, like, I don't know. I don't know why they wear the Speedos. I mean, I don't mind. I'm a girl, though, so...
That's true. I mean, it's a bunch of gay guys jumping off a diving board. That can't make you too excited, can it?
I like watching the diving, but I like it because it's cool. I don't really care about, like, the Speedos. I think it's just pretty impressive what they do.
Well, what performance were you most impressed with Phelps, or were you impressed with Usain Bolt?
I was more impressed with Usain Bolt because Phelps, we already expected to come in and win a bunch of medals. You know, that is not like seeing him win a bunch of medals was like a surprise. Usain Bolt, there was a lot of, you know, questioning about him, if, you know, he could win it or if he had, you kind of lost some of his, you know, his spark, you know, people, there was a lot of questions about him. The fact that he, and it wasn't the 100 meters I watched, it wasn't even close. It wasn't even that close, really, not for a race that quick. And then he won the 200, so I was impressed that he won both. And really, like I said, it wasn't even that close when you really looked at it.
Well, and I mean, he could easily set a world record every time he goes out on the track. And it looks so effortless when he runs.
When it's like, one of the commentators said when I was watching the 100 meters, is like, for them to compete, like, forget just beating Usain Bolt, for them to, like, challenge him, they had to run their all-time best. They had to run a personal best just to compete.
Yeah.
And it's like,
yeah.
He didn't even have to run his best to win. He won anyways. That was, like, well, the 100 meters was, like, his second best time recorded. He didn't even have to run his best. And everyone else had to run personal best just to have a hope of possibly beating him, which they didn't, but just to compete with him, they have to run their best.
Well, are you, I mean, a lot of, it's tough. I mean, the Olympics are over. It's kind of, I mean, the last 4 days are really boring of the Olympics. Mm-hmm. It's like the first week is a lot of fun. And then once the track and field, once you kind of see who the best is, you know who's going to win the gold. There's no surprises in the track and field, really.
I didn't even watch the last couple of days of the Olympics, to be honest.
Well, it gets so boring and bogged down. Are you glad it's over? Or, I mean, because I'm more so, I never get the feeling like I'm left wanting more of the Olympics. Do you ever get that feeling?
No, I'm kind of over the Olympics. The only reason I'm sad is that now all we have is baseball till football season starts. I mean, we have preseason, yeah. But people buy in way too much to preseason. I don't really follow preseason that much because it doesn't count for anything. And people just read way too much into it. So I don't really pay too much attention because, I mean, the starters only play 5 minutes, you know.
Well, speaking of football, you got a significant injury, I guess, to Jason Witten if he needs surgery on his spleen.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, I don't really care because I'm a Giants fan, so that's good news for me. But do you think that the Cowboys, even with a healthy Witten, are a Super Bowl contending team?
No. Everybody, every year, I mean, I've been saying this for the last, every year people say, pick the Cowboys to make the Super Bowl. No, this is their year. No, this is their year. Oh, they're going to make it this year. Every year I say no, and every year I'm right, and people are saying it again, and I'm going to say it once more. No. They've been picked to make the Super Bowl the last couple years, and, you know, the last 2 years, they haven't even made the playoffs, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm like, to me, Tony Romo is a solid quarterback, but he's not a Super Bowl quarterback. I hate to tell you, it's just the way it is. And they're just, no, I don't. I question if they'll make playoffs, more or less a Super Bowl.
Well, in the NFC East, I mean, Robert Griffin III, every team is better than the Cowboys. I mean,
yeah,
the Giants just won the Super Bowl.
They have a tough division.
Yeah, nobody's, there's no cakewalk in the NFC East.
No,
I mean,
you have
somebody's going to make it with a 9-7 record.
Yeah, that's that could be the toughest division in the NFL.
Oh, yeah, that and, I mean, I would throw even the AFC North in that conversation, too, with how good those teams are right now with an up-and-coming Browns team. The Bengals were good last year. I think the Bengals are going to come back down to earth. Do you think they come back down to earth as well?
Yes, I think they got kind of lucky last year. I don't see them being a playoff contender this year, but we'll see.
With the two rookie quarterbacks, though, that Griffin and Luck, who were you more impressed with in their preseason opener, or did you really care?
Like I said, I don't really care that much because I don't read too much into preseason because everyone's kind of, you know, they don't play very minutes and everyone's a little bit more cautious. No one's going all out because they don't want to, you know, injure themselves in preseason, you know. But from what I've seen so far, I'm more impressed with Griffin. But he's also has the better team, too.
Do you think he has more of an upside because he's so raw as far as he has less, like, he didn't really start developing a passing game until he tore his ACL, or tore up his knee when he was, I think, a sophomore. And now he's been forced to, he had to kind of learn how to play quarterback versus just be an unbelievable athlete playing quarterback. Do you think that he has more of an upside than Luck, or do you think Luck has more upside with how great his brain is?
That's a hard one. I think Luck maybe have a little bit more upside with the brain, but that's a tough one. I think Luck may be the smarter quarterback just from football IQ, but I think Griffin's more athletic. But, you know, I think Griffin's going to have the better season. People keep asking me that, and I say Griffin because he's got the better team around him.
Well, do you, going forward, do you, in the NFC South, it's been a worst of first division for years. Everybody, if you finish last, you usually finish first the next year. The Carolina Panthers finally ended that notion, but do you think the Panthers can make a run at this division with the Saints being down, with all their coaches being suspended? Do you think that the Falcons are a legit title contender, or do you think Matt Ryan's a fraud? Where do you see this division winding up?
I think the Panthers could end up number one. I think it's the Panthers and the Falcons will be 1 and 2, but I think the Panthers could challenge for the number one seed in that division. I do. Matt Ryan, to me, is like Tony Romo. He's a good quarterback, but he's not a Super Bowl quarterback, and he's proven that. You know, every year they make playoffs, and every year he can't win a playoff game. He always falls apart in playoffs. And, you know, the Panthers are going to be tough. That's another one of my sleeper teams. I think everyone expects them to be good, but I think they're going to be better than people expect.
Do you think that in the NFC, who right now do you think is the clear-cut best team?
Right now in the NFC?
Yeah.
I would probably have to go with the Packers, but I'm a little biased towards Packers, or the Giants, being the defending champions.
What about the Eagles? Do you think that they are fool's gold again this year?
I love my Eagles, but they need to stay healthy. They already have some injuries. They really need to stay healthy. And they're in that same division. They're in a tough, tough, tough division. It's going to be interesting to see what happens. I think they're either going to come out and be really, really good and surprise people, or they're going to be really horrible. I think there's not going to be an in-between.
Now, we're gonna talk a little AFC East, and we're not going to mention a five-letter word or a four-letter word. I'm going to talk about the Dolphins. And the Dolphins, they just got rid of Chad Ochocinco, or Chad Johnson, whatever the hell you want to call him, or wife beater, whatever you want to call him.
Piece of crap?
Yeah, piece of crap. Are you surprised they ended up letting him go? I thought that, with her history, I thought they should have let the legal system play itself out until they decided to cut him. What are your thoughts on?
I thought they would have just held on to him. I'm with you. I thought they would just let the legal system handle him and they would just go from there. I didn't think they would cut him so quickly. But I don't really blame them. You know.
Do you think Chad plays another down in the NFL?
Yeah, I think some team is going to be stupid enough to pick him up and he'll play. Kind of like Seahawks did with Terrell Owens. Bunch of idiots.
Well, what do you think of that deal? Do you think that that's going to go south on him? Or,
yes.
Well, couldn't it even go south on him because they're not very good at it?
He got dropped. He was playing in the Arena Football League. The Arena. Okay, that's like where the washed-up NFL players, the players that can't make it in the NFL go. And he got dropped by his team. Okay? Think about how pathetic that is for a second. Of course it's going to go south. And what has he done in recent years anyways before that?
Actually, let me correct you. He was in the Indoor Football League, which is a step below the Arena Football League.
Okay, tomatoes.
No, I'm just saying it's lower. So he was playing in a worse league. And he had ownership of the team. So it doesn't even really count as playing football at that point.
No. So, no, I think I couldn't believe when I saw that. Are they stupid? Wow. Like, I couldn't believe that. No, that's going to go south. Like, he hasn't done anything since he was, like, with the 49ers. I see that going bad. I don't I didn't like that move. I was really disappointed in the Seahawks when they did that.
Well, do you think that, I mean, they have Marshawn Lynch, who's Skittles and drinking and driving expert. Do you think that the Seahawks can do anything in that division? Matt Flynn, please. He had one good game. Has there been a quarterback that got a contract off of one good game and succeeded? I can't think of one.
They're going downhill fast. The only thing that works in their favor is the fact that their division sucks.
That's
the only thing that works in their favor, because they suck, but so does their division. I mean, weren't they the ones that the year the Saints won, weren't they the ones that like made the Super Bowl with a losing record?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, they were like 9-7, they were 8-8 or something. They barely got to 10 wins by getting to the Super Bowl.
Yeah. So, I mean, their division is horrible. So, even though they suck because the division's so bad, they stand a chance of making it. I don't think they will. They're a mess. They're just horrible.
Who in the AFC right now do you think that Peyton Manning can make that Denver team click, or do you think that they're still a year away with him?
I think they're still a year away. I think he can make it click, but again, I think it takes time. So will they be a big threat this year? Of course. If you have Peyton Manning, you're going to be a threat. You know, they'll make playoffs, but I don't think they're going to challenge for a Super Bowl this year. I think next year they'll challenge for the Super Bowl. In the AFC, I think people need to watch out actually for the Ravens.
Ooh. Yeah. Why the Ravens? Do you think Flacco can get them over the hump?
They've been knocking on the door for a long time, and what I've noticed about teams that knock on the door for a while is eventually they get there. The Colts did the same thing before they won theirs. They were getting really close there for a long time. Then they finally got over the hump, and they won. Green Bay was close for a couple years before they won theirs. So they've been knocking on the door for a long time now. They've gotten so close, and you know that field goal kick, you know, they were so close. I think if it's going to happen, it's going to happen this year.
Well, and even without a Terrell Suggs, do you think that injury is going to hurt them as much as people think?
No, because their defense is just so good. Their defense is just too good. I don't think it's going to hurt them that much.
You think the bringing in of Todd Haley as the offensive coordinator for the Steelers is going to be a huge problem with Big Ben being Big Ben after the motorcycle accident and after his problems with the ladies. He's become pretty stand-up citizen, but he hasn't won any Super Bowls. Do you think that he finally gets back on the horse and starts playing Big Ben type football again?
I hope not. I'm not a Ben Roethlisberger fan. They'll be good, but I don't think they're gonna challenge for the Super Bowl either. I don't think so. No.
Do you say that because you're a woman, or do you say that because that you're not a Big Ben fan?
I say it partly because I'm a woman, and so you know, and partly because I don't think he's all that reformed. I think a lot of it's just an act. I think a lot of it's a front that he puts on. I don't think he's really changed that much. But then part of it is I think he's just an idiot. I mean, who goes out and rides a motorcycle without a helmet?
Well, I mean, yeah, I can't think of too many people, right? Well, there's a lot of people in Council Bluffs, Iowa that do it, but it's not like they have careers to worry about.
No, I just think he's an idiot, and yeah, it's probably because I'm a woman.
Right now, who do you like meeting in the Super Bowl? My last few years, I picked Packers, Ravens the year the Packers went to the Super Bowl. I'm thinking Packers and I'm going to go with the sleeper pick. I'm going to say the Chargers finally break through.
No.
Yes. Because, I mean, Phillip Rivers is going to have a bounce back year. And I think Ryan Matthews is going to be, once he recovers from this injury, I think he's going to want more money at some point in his career. I think that finally clicks. And I think this team's got a shot.
I'm going to go with the one that you went a couple years ago. I'm going to go Packers-Ravens. I think Joe Flacco knows that he needs to get it done. I think, you know, Ray Lewis knows that this is it. I think that team knows that they've been too close for too long and they need to get it done. I'm going Packers Ravens right now.
Last thing before I let you go. Who gets out of jail, or who has a bigger year, Peyton Manning or Dwight Howard?
Who has a better year, Peyton Manning or Dwight Howard?
Yes.
Peyton Manning.
neck versus back. I mean, those are two tough ones to come back from.
And I'd say
Dwight's only had one.
I think Peyton Manning has the heart. I don't think Dwight Howard has it.
But Dwight Howard's got 5 kids to feed.
That's his own fault.
Do you want to talk about Topic Thunder really quick before I let you go?
I need to write some things, actually. I haven't written anything. I've been so busy this summer, you know, working a lot and all kinds. I haven't written anything recently, so I need to get on that right now, actually.
You need to write about how much you hate Dwight Howard.
I was thinking about writing an article about why Thunder fans should not be that concerned.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, you need to sell why we shouldn't be worried.
Yeah, I'm gonna get on that article. I should have some time this weekend. It's been a crazy, crazy summer for me. So I'm gonna get on that. Hopefully have that article done in the next couple of days. And then I was also thinking about doing a Ibaka versus Harden article, because a lot of people are talking about if one of them has to go, which one should go, and this and that. So though they're both under contract for next season, but
we don't have to worry about it for too long, but we do have to worry about it.
And yeah, it's definitely something that they're going to have to worry about at the end of this season.
Make sure you throw in that Perkins might have to get amnesty to make that happen.
Yeah, which is fine.
That's the attitude.
I have faith in my team.
Well, Alyssa, I appreciate you coming on. Always a pleasure to have you on.
Anytime.